Well, hello, my fellow concerned people for the regional rail. There's no other spot I could actually record this today, being that this was the last bridge ever to be used by the South Australian iconic train, the Bluebird. Sadly, in 1982, the last Bluebird to roll over this bridge, Adelaide bound, was the Bluebird that departed from Roseworthy to Adelaide in 1982. This was the last time the Bluebird was ever on these lines. And having a look back at there now, you would not believe that this line once was the most vital rail links in Australia. So in honour of the Bluebird rail car, I would like to tell you a little bit about how it actually came about. But not just the Bluebird, but also the Red Hens, another iconic rail car of South Australia. In 1951, the Commonwealth Government purchased three Bud cars from America, the BC series. Now, they were a luxury train, fully equipped with air conditioning, reclining seats, a restroom, and also double windows with your shades in between, and steps to actually aboard the train and alight the train without a platform. Now, the Bud cars were delivered or transported to Port Augusta, where they were unloaded, and they were basically put to test first. And one of the Bud cars had its maiden journey here in South Australia and crossed the border to Western Australia with a town called Kalgoorlie. Now, that was its maiden journey, and it was a success from what I have been told. What they wanted, it was achieved. So with that, again, in 1951, they were put into service in regional South Australia. So they were a rail car that was to service Whyalla, Port Augusta, Port Pirie, and they would even go over to New South Wales, Broken Hill, as a passenger service. Now, with that, the South Australian government, obviously, had to come up with a regional rail service for regional rail, such as this line I'm actually on now, which used to go to Peterborough, but first it would get to Roseworthy, which is the next town up, and then it would branch off in two directions. It would branch off to, say, Freeling, and the other line would continue north. And then from there, it would branch out into other regional towns and regional South Australia. So what the South Australian government did was they obviously got their hands on some great engineers and great designers. They sat them down with the blueprint of the Bud car. In the 1960s, the design of the Bluebird popped up, and it was all because of the Bud car. They used the blueprints, as I've mentioned, to design a second luxury car which was going to be used on this line and all other regional rail lines across South Australia. Now, the Bluebird was also a luxury train. It had your steps to board the train without a platform. It had air conditioning, reclining seats, also a restroom, and also your double windows with your shades in between. So with that, it took into service from the 1960s to the last train in 1982, where the last train actually rolled across this bridge for the very last time from Roseworthy, Adelaide bound. Now, they then come up with a second design, a basic design of South Australia's Red Hen, which is, if you have ever travelled on a Red Hen or been to South Australia and you used to see the old diesel Red Hens, you either love them or you hate them. There was no in between. I'm actually a lover of them. They should be still here under heritage, but sadly, most of them have actually been scrapped, as well as the most of the bluebirds also got scrapped. So the Red Hens and the bluebirds were a offspin of the Bud Car, but when they designed them, they also designed them lengthwise a bit shorter, so that it suited more to the South Australian type, I should say, and not so lengthy. So that's the history and the of the Bud Car, and how the bluebirds and the Red Hens actually come about. Now, I'll also add, they were actually also made here at the Islington Railworks, same as a lot of the locos which you used to see many years ago lugging around all the freight across regional South Australia and interstate. They were all made here at the Islington Railworks. And for that, the bluebird and the Red Hens and the locos become a part of South Australia's rail history. Tier 2 is also facing the same destruction as the line which we've also just been at, and also the open to the elements of no maintenance being done on them. It's quite sad to see it. The sleepers are actually, they're wearing away where people have walked over them for so many years and the sleepers haven't been replaced. Just up further, there's also another sleeper that the end is burnt off. Someone has decided to light it up, as the vandals do. Just also at the start of this bridge, there used to be a signal for the movement to Goolabound, but again, the vandalism has claimed that one, and they actually have ripped the whole system out the ground, making ARTC come through, or Genesee Wyoming come through, and literally, obviously, isolate this section of the line from their tracking system. It's very sad to see the bridge like this, because I used to play around here as a kid. We always knew to be careful because it was an active line. But now, it's just a shame.
I'm not.